Hi, my loves. Today we're going to make steamed Persian rice using 3 cups of basmati rice, 1 tablespoon of sea salt, and 120 grams of butter. Let's get started. This Persian quick rice called kete does not need the preparation that the steamed Persian rice requires. I have a video on steamed Persian rice, so please check that out. There's no need to parboil the rice before the steaming stage, and the amount of water used in the recipe cooks the rice to perfect tenderness, and then it is steamed. Start by washing the rice 2 to 3 times in cold water. After the third wash, drain as much of the water as possible. Go ahead and add 1 tablespoon of sea salt and 4.5 cups of water to your rice cooker or non-stick pot. We want the temperature to be on high-medium heat as we want to bring the water to a boil. Remember to keep the rice to water ratio 1 to 1.5. Next, add 60 grams of butter to your boiled water. What I love about this dish is that it is made in one pot from start to finish without saffron or tadig in about 30 minutes. Feel free to use ghee or any vegetable oil instead of butter. Although I mentioned that you need 1.5 cups of water for every cup of rice, keep in mind that the quality of basmati rice varies from brand to brand, so you may need to add less or more water depending on the quality of your basmati rice. You may have to cook this dish a few times with your particular choice of basmati rice to really understand how much water you should add to achieve the perfect result. While my butter is melting, go ahead and subscribe to my channel and don't forget to smash that like button. Keep in mind that when making kete, the rice grains don't come out all nice and separate. The results can be loosely compared to sticky rice. Once your butter has been mostly melted, go ahead and add your rinsed out rice to your rice cooker or non-stick pot. This style of rice is healthier than the fluffy, pretty Persian rice you might know from restaurants because all the nutrients stay within the rice, whereas with the other kind of steamed Persian rice, most of the nutrients get flushed away in the making process. In Persian cuisine, there are different ways to prepare rice. This style of rice is probably the easiest way to start your Persian cooking journey with. Okay, I'm gonna let this cook on high-medium heat until the water is completely absorbed. Later, I will reduce the heat to low-medium and let it steam for about 10 minutes. As you can see, my rice has been fully cooked and is ready to be served. But we have one more step left, and that is adding another 60 grams of butter to the rice. The longer you leave your rice on the heat, the crispier the outside becomes. At this time, turn off your heat and just allow some time for the butter to completely melt. The rice will absorb all that butter, making the rice smell and taste even better. Check out the description box down below for all the details about this recipe. I'm also gonna add the links to my favorite rice cookers so you can access them. This method of rice cooking is rich in vitamin B as we did not drain the rice. The rice is fully cooked and ready to be served. I simply removed the lid, put a flat white plate on top of it, and then I gripped the pot and the plate and overturned it. And as you can see, the final result looks amazing and delicious. The rice has absorbed all that butter and it looks phenomenal. I hope you liked watching this video and learned a new recipe. Please don't forget to share your thoughts in the comment section and follow me on Instagram @flavorsomekitchen. See you in my next video!